In this video, I will show you how to sum values if the criteria cells are not blank in Excel like this. So let's get started. Here in this Excel sheet, I have some order data containing product code, color and amount. Some of the color value cells are blank or missing from the order details. Now I want to sum the order amounts if the color cell is blank as well as if the color cell is not blank. To sum the cells not equal to a specific value, we can use the Excel SUMIF function. The SUMIF function returns the sum of the values in a range that meets the specified condition. This function accepts three arguments: a range, a criteria, and an optional sum range. Let's first sum the amount if the product color is not blank by typing an equal sign in the target cell. Now type SUMIF followed by an opening bracket. Since we want to compare the color, let's select the range of the cells containing the product color as the first argument. Type not equal to sign in the double quotes as the criteria argument, which means not equal to blank. We want to sum the amount if the color is not blank, so let's select the cells containing the order amount as the sum range argument. Type the closing bracket and hit the enter key to complete the formula. As you can see, we now have the sum of the order amount if the product color is not blank. Let's sum the numbers if the color is blank. I will use the same SUMIF formula, except that I will use empty double quotes as the criteria argument like this. As you can see, we now have the sum of the numbers if the product color is blank. We can also use the SUMIFS function instead of the SUMIF function. The SUMIFS function returns the sum of the values in a range that meets multiple criteria. We can specify more than one pair of range and criteria using this function. Please note that the order of the arguments of the SUMIFS function is different from the SUMIF function. To get the sum of numbers if the product color is not blank using the SUMIFS function, I will select the amount range as the first sum range argument, product color range as the second criteria range argument, and not equal to sign as the third criteria argument. Similarly, to get the sum of the amount if the product color is empty, I will select the order amount range as the first argument, the product color range as the second argument, and empty value as the criteria argument. As you can see, we now have the sum of the numbers if the product color is not empty or empty. We can also use the SUMPRODUCT function to sum the numbers if the cell is not empty. Here is the formula to do that. This part of the formula compares the color cells with the empty value using the not equal to sign. This comparison returns an array of 5 elements containing true and false values. A true value is returned if the cell is not blank, false otherwise. The Boolean multiplication operation converts the true and false values to 1 and 0 respectively. These 1 and 0 values are then multiplied with the respective amount cells. The amount cells having the non-blank color value are multiplied by 1, thus remaining as is, and the empty amount cells are multiplied by 0, thus becoming 0. This multiplication operation returns an array of 5 elements containing 12, 0, 10, 0, and 8. Finally, the SUMPRODUCT function sums up these amounts and the result is 30. Let's also sum the amount if the product color is blank using a similar SUMPRODUCT formula. This time, I will compare the product color cells with an empty string using the equal to sign. The rest of the formula remains the same like this. As you can see, we now have the sum of the numbers if the color is not blank or it is blank. Watch these videos for more Excel tips, tricks and how-to tutorials. If you found this video helpful, please like the video and subscribe to our channel.